Welcome students. In this, potential due to three concentric spherical shells. Given that potential at A is equal to potential at C, then obtain the relation between ABC, where A, B, C are the radius of respective shells. First, let us see the shell C. Shell C. The shell C is given here. Shell C is this one is given charge density of plus sigma. See, we know sigma, that is surface charge density, is equal to charge divided by area. Here the area is a shell, so it will be 4 pi into the radius square, and charge is equal to charge. Or charge of, see, if it is given plus charge, plus if the surface charge density is plus, then charge will be also plus. It means here a positive charge is given, that is Q of C plus. So now we can write Q of C. What is Q of C? Q of C is equal to sigma into area. Q. Charge is equal to sigma into A. So Q charge in C is equal to plus sigma into area of the this one, which is having a radius of C, into 4 pi C square. Pi R square, R radius is equal to C square, or we can write Q C is equal to sigma into 4 pi C square, and surface charge density is equal to charge divided by area. Same way, now let us come to shell B. Shell B is given in negative charge. So shell B is given a negative surface charge density. It means negative charge density for B, and this will be also B. And charge on B. What is charge on B? Charge on B is equal to minus sigma. Sigma on B, admitting minus sigma into 4B. What is the radius? Radius of this one is equal to, this is equal to B. So this will be B square. So QB we can write minus sigma 4 pi B square. Same way, for shell we have written C, and for shell A it is given plus. It means plus, this will be plus of A 4 pi r square. So charge in A is equal to plus sigma into area, where plus sigma, and for A is equal to plus sigma into 4 pi, its radius for shell, the radius is E. So we can write charge in A is equal to plus, this is equal to minus, this is equal to plus sigma 4 pi A square. So there should not be any confusion between this one, because surface charge density charge divided by area. If it is plus, this will be also plus. If it is minus, this will be minus. That's all. There should not be any confusion. Now given, what is given the condition? The condition given is potential at A is equal to potential at C. Now let us see what is potential at A. Let us find out potential at C. Potential at C is equal to, C is here. This is center point. C is here at a distance of C from the center, and it is having a charge of plus Q or plus sigma. So what is potential at the surface? At this point, the potential is equal to K into charge. Charge is plus charge at C. C charge divided by the distance is C. So we can say potential C is equal to potential due to shell C, outer shell, outer shell having charge plus Q on its surface. So potential at C is equal to C. What is this? This is equal to K into sigma C, sigma in C divided by C. First thing. Second thing, second part. See, now the potential we have to find out, because this also having a charge of plus Q, minus Q, and this will be also give potential at this point, because we are going to, why? Because this is O, this is B, this is outside, this point C is outside, so total distance is R, which is equal to, the distance is equal to C. What is potential at this point? The potential due to this charge, that is minus Q, will give potential at this point outside its the shell, which is equal to minus, is equal to K. So we can say plus potential due to shell B at outside on C. So this is having a charge of minus Q. It will, and at this point, which is outside the shell, it will give potential of K into at this point, what potential this will give, this shell, K into minus Q QB divided by the distance, because here R is equal to C. So this point will be plus, or we can say K into minus Q C. Now here plus into K into minus QB divided by C, right? Now third one is, this is O and this is C. This is A having a charge of plus Q, that is Q, and this is a point, this point is outside for the shell. So it means the distance, outside at a distance, R is equal to C. It means what is the potential due to this one at this point? This point for the shell, this point is outside. So this is equal to K into Q into A divided by the distance is equal to R. R which is nothing but this is R, which is nothing but the C. So we can write plus K into Q at Q due to A divided by C. See, always for this point it is outside at a distance of C, and for this point this point is outside, which is at a distance of C, and this on the surface it is also same. So now we have taken all this one now out. So we will calculate what is potential at C. Potential at C is due to its own, and due to this B at this point, due to A at this point, which we have written here, or we can take K into QC. What is QC? What is QC is equal to? QC is equal to sigma 4 pi into C square by C plus this plus into minus will become minus K into QB. QB is equal to minus of sigma, so which is equal to minus of QB is equal to 4 pi into radius square B square, 4 pi B square divided by QQ. Why? Because the minus QB, minus because QB is equal to minus B, so we will write QB. QB is equal to minus sigma K into minus sigma 4 pi B square divided by C plus this one QA. K into QA is equal to sigma into 4 pi A square by C. Therefore, if you take outside potential at C is equal to k into sigma into 4 pi outside. This and this will cancel. C minus, so this will be plus. Minus, plus minus minus will be out. K we have taken out, sigma we have taken, 4 pi we have taken, minus b square by c plus a square by c. This is, so it means Vc we have found out. V potential at c due to all the three shells is equal to k into sigma into 4 pi divided by c minus b square by c plus a square by c. Now let us find out, we have found out potential at c. Now let us find out potential at a. What is potential at a? You have to remember the funda. If your potential on the surface is equal to k into charge divided by the distance. But for this point also will give potential at this point, which is equal to k into charge on this shell and the distance r. At this point also, k into charge divided by this distance, because this point is outside for this one. So we know how to calculate for a potential for point outside. Now we have calculated Vc. Now Va, what is Va? Va is equal to, this is the point Va from O. So due to Va, it will have plus Q charge here. It is having plus Q charge because Va is having a plus Q charge at this point. So potential due to Va, due to its own on the surface, is equal to K into plus Q divided by distance is equal to A. Distance is equal to A. So we can write K into Q, QA divided by A. So this is QA first. Now second point, this is point A, this is O, and this is B. And for this is outside point, which is at a distance of R, which is equal to, R which is equal to, what is the surface potential at this point? K into its charge, QB divided by the distance is R. R is equal to B. And the same potential is available here because in this shell, charges are inside. Charges are inside is same, potential is same inside. At this surface, whatever is there, it is available here also. And same thing is available at these points also. So, is equal to plus K into, what is charge here? QB is equal to, QB is a negative charge, minus QB divided by the distance. What is the distance? Distance from here is B plus. Now, let us take one more point. This is O, we have taken due to A, we have taken for B, and this is C. What is potential here? It is having K into its charge is equal to plus QC divided by this distance is R is equal to C divided by C, because for A this is outside. So outside this is the charge, and the same charge is available everywhere up to, because potential is constant inside the shell. So same potential is available at this point also. So we can write K into QC divided by C. This is the potential at this point. Now, this one thing you have to remember, you should be able to calculate very fast, because potential at this point is equal to potential charge due to this point, which is outside, which is at a distance C, potential at this point, and this is available here also because potential is constant inside, and at this point, which is at a distance B, and this same potential is available inside this shell, and at this A also we have written. That's all. So this is equal to K into QA. What is QA? Is equal to sigma 4 pi into a square, sigma 4 pi a square divided by a plus. This plus into minus minus will become k into qb. Qb is equal to, qb as it is we have written minus sigma into 4 pi b square divided by b plus k into qc. Qc is equal to sigma into 4 pi into c square divided by c. So potential at A is equal to k into sigma into 4 pi out. Then it means A minus B plus C. So potential at B is equal to potential at A is equal to k into sigma into 4 pi into A minus B plus C. A minus B plus C. So we found out now. Now what is this? He said the potential at A is equal to, the condition is potential at A is equal to potential at B. At B, it means potential A is equal to potential at C. That is K sigma 4 pi into C minus B square by C plus A square by C. This is potential at C. Potential C is equal to potential at A, k into sigma into 4 pi by A minus B plus C. A minus B plus C. So in this condition we can cancel this becomes C plus A minus B, A square minus B square by C is equal to A minus B plus C. We can write this way. So this C and this C get cancelled. If it is go outside, it becomes C. This will become A plus B into A minus B divided by C is equal to A minus B. So we can cancel A minus B. So it means this becomes A plus B, A plus B. And the C will go here. This is one is equal to C. So the relation between A plus B is equal to radius of shell A plus radius of shell B is equal to radius of shell C. This is the relation we have find out.